Great, thank you. Well, it was 2010, and I had just been hired as the vision implementation pastor for our church. It was a very part-time position, but I was super eager to be hired anywhere in my field and in my calling. I was announced by the senior pastor my first Sunday as having the same credentials as him. We went to the same seminary. I served communion and I preached. But within weeks, my title, they have informed me, had changed from vision implementation pastor to now vision implementation person. The church had decided that they couldn't call me a pastor, even though I was ordained as an elder in the Free Methodist Church. The pastor and the board wouldn't step up to address the issue at the very core of who we are as Free Methodists, the people that stand up against oppression of any kind, including oppression of women. And the people who had refused to tithe to the church if I was considered a pastor got their way. Well, fast forward to a year ago. I was interviewing, this time for a senior pastor of a church, and throughout the interview, a man on the board refused to acknowledge me. He actually wouldn't even look at me. No one who knew what was happening stopped the meeting and said, "Whoa, this isn't okay, and we need to address this before we move on." No, the interview progressed and it ended, and later I learned that the man wouldn't acknowledge me because he didn't want a woman as a senior pastor. I share these with you to open up my very brief talk today because, fellow Free Methodists, we have a ways to go. Just because you don't see the oppression of women in your church doesn't mean it's not happening in subtle ways. One glance at the leadership in the Free Methodist Church on our headquarters website, we can see that we are far from being equitable when it comes to women in leadership in our denomination. So tonight I have 10 minutes, and so I'm going to give you the fast forward version of why we support women at all levels of leadership and equality in the church, the home, and in the world as Free Methodists, and how we can do better when it comes to valuing women, especially in the church. Let's start with the very beginning, with creation. Many people start by pointing to Genesis and the use of the word helper in Genesis 2:18, but a word study would indicate that the only other time this specific word is used elsewhere in the Old Testament is only in reference to God. So this can't be a term used in reference to subordination. In fact, the image we get when we read the creation account is this beautiful design of humanity created in God's image and a strong sense of mutuality right there in the garden. Even in the fall, we see that because of their choices, the results are consequences of sin and living in a fallen world, not commands. But the overarching hope and message of the Bible is the way we see God redeeming his people through history, covenant after covenant, until Jesus comes into the picture. And when Jesus shows up on the scene, we see him welcoming women and welcoming women to learn from him. He speaks openly with them. He interacts with them. He comforts women who felt rejected. He taught women when that was unheard of. Jesus made space for women and included them in a culture that very much excluded them. Sin and the consequence of the fall may plague us until Jesus' return, but that doesn't mean we aren't partners with him to bring the kingdom to fruition. We are, in essence, between the trees. The tree in Eden, which symbolizes the perfect place that God had created, and then the tree of life spoken about in Revelation. We are headed towards the kingdom of God, and we partner with Jesus and his example by ushering in his kingdom and how we treat all people and love our neighbor. This means, friends, that we don't shrug our shoulders when we see oppression take place. Why? We stood up against slavery way back in 1816, and it's the very core of who we are. We are Free Methodists, which means we take seriously our work in the kingdom of God and not simply saying, "Well, heaven will restore that someday." No, we partner together and we act boldly as we move heaven a little closer to earth. I think sometimes we miss the big picture of the Bible and how we partner with Jesus in the work of seeing the kingdom fully, the way God is redeeming us to himself. We don't have time to cover every passage used to keep women from leadership in the church, but I do want to point out that there are definitely some passages that when you read as is, you might wonder, did Paul think women should be silent in church, or did he think them to be subordinate to men? And when we study these passages in depth and we look at the context more closely, we see that this is not the case. Oftentimes he's speaking to a specific group or specific issues. However, when we look at other instances in which Paul speaks, we see that he sees no division in the body of Christ. And in Galatians 3:28, he says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male or female, all are one in Christ. One of the passages that stands out to help us understand how Paul felt about women in ministry is Romans 16. Take some time to visit that passage, maybe even tonight. Paul introduces Phoebe as a servant of the church, and he encourages his listeners to welcome her. He then goes on to list no less than 10 women who he wants to encourage and send greetings to them in their ministries and work for the kingdom. When you read this text, it's hard to imagine that Paul didn't want women preaching the good news. If you have more questions, our Free Methodist headquarters website is a great place to go. It's a great resource. Our Study Commission on Doctrine has several articles, and you can read our position on women in the church, home, and in the world in the Book of Discipline. This issue isn't up for debate, friends. This is one of the many ways we partner with God in bringing the kingdom into fruition. Our founders, B.T. Roberts, wrote a book called Ordaining Women, and even now there's an updated copy that you can get right on Amazon. Bishop Kendall recently wrote a book called Follow Her Lead. If you have questions, please take some time to read the website or order these books, and make sure you know our position on women in the church, home, and world. Now you might be asking, what can I do to help women in the Free Methodist Church? And I'm more than happy to give you some practical advice that might help make our denomination a more equitable place for women. First, be mindful of curriculum and books that you use in your congregations. Be careful that they line up with our view on women. Nothing can be more confusing to your church than saying you support women on all levels in ministry and in the home when you are using marriage books and curriculum that speaks differently. Do the research needed to know if the information you are presenting to your congregation views women in the same way that we do as a denomination. Second, don't hire only from your networks. Oftentimes, women are left out of these connections. Making the job posting available to everyone gives opportunities to more than just your network. Women can't apply if they don't know about openings. I'm in the position I am today because my superintendent took time to post the opening publicly. I wouldn't have known about it otherwise. Third, pay women equally if at all possible. You know, some women volunteer and many do so because they can't find paid positions or maybe they're even in a position to maybe do so. And many men do ministry without any pay as well. But women are often overlooked for pay because they aren't viewed as the main breadwinner. This is not equitable. And in many ways, it continues the cycle of oppression. I'm friends with a pastor who has been at a church a long time, but has been overlooked multiple times for a raise, while her male colleague has received several raises. Choose to pay women in the same way you would a man. Value her worth the way you would anyone else. And then finally, when you see women being treated poorly, step in, especially if you have the power to do so. Many women are scared to speak up for themselves for fear of retaliation because, unfortunately, it has happened to too many of us. When you see oppression taking place, speak up, educate, or ask for help from someone at a higher level than you. Please don't look the other way when you see women treated unfairly. Friends, this is a gospel issue and a kingdom issue. If we are partners with God in ushering in the kingdom, we need to address how we treat women. I've been pastoring in the Free Methodist Church for close to 20 years. There have been significant strides made in support of women in ministry. But we can't think we have arrived on this issue. Please join us as we embrace biblical equality and we work together to end the systemic oppression of women in the church, the family, and in the world. It starts with us, my fellow Free Methodists. Thank you.